Hi, I'm Dave Long from StaticWorx. Just like the video we made yesterday, I'm at home again. Guessing you are too. So what I discussed yesterday was the difference between low KV carpet and static dissipative carpet. Today we're going to continue in that discussion, but today we're going to talk about conductivity. So what I've done is I've gathered together a bunch of meters that measure electrical resistance. So this is what's called a digital ohm meter. I have a handheld meter with two blades on the bottom where we measure the resistance between the blades. And I have an analog meter which represents the electrical resistance by these various numbers that are on here. And for those of you who like math, the numbers are logarithmic. So it goes from 10 to the third to 10 to the fourth to 10 to the fifth, all the way up to 10 to the 13th. And all that means is that at 10 to the third, we're talking about something that's 1,000 ohms. At 10 to the fourth, we're talking about 10,000. At 10 to the fifth, we're talking about 100,000. So each number, the actual numerical representation grows by a factor of 10. So like yesterday, I have a low KV carpet, which if you look closely at the bottom of it, has a light colored material backing. And I have static dissipative carpet, where the backing is a little bit darker than this material. And here's a piece of low KV carpet. You can see the big difference between the two colors. That's because this has carbon at the bottom of it, which is a conductor, and this doesn't have any. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on this meter, and I'm going to measure the electrical resistance just simply between two points on the carpet tile. So when I press the button, as you can see, I'm measuring between 10 and 11. That means 10 to the 10th to 10 to the 11th. So to give you some perspective, 10 to the 9th is 1 billion. So 10 to the 10th is 10 billion. So this has an electrical resistance of over 10 billion ohms. In order for us to call a product static safe and for that product to be used in applications where we need to reduce static electricity, it has to measure under 9, which is 10 to the 9th, which I just told you is a billion. So with this meter, I'm measuring something that's clearly not acceptable. Now I'm going to take the two probes, put them on the static dissipative carpet, make the same measurement, and I'm measuring less than 10 to the 8th. So by definition, any material that measures between 6 and 9 is called a static dissipative material. If it measures less than 6, it's called a conductive material. And for those of you who are writing specifications for applications like call centers or FAA flight towers or server rooms, you don't want the flooring material to measure less than 10 to the 6th. I'll give you an example of that. Here's a material, it's got a black back on it. When I put the two probes on it, it measures less than 10 to the fifth. That's a piece of conductive carpet. That would not be acceptable if the requirement for the application called for static dissipative. So what we've got is regular carpet, highly conductive carpet, and static dissipative carpet. Let's pull out the probes. Let's plug them into a different meter. The reason the meter says good, it doesn't mean there's anything special going on. The battery's good. And hit test. And the conductive carpet is measuring 6 times 10 to the fourth. If the application calls for a material that measures greater than 10 to the sixth, this is two orders of magnitude too conductive. Let's put the probes on the static dissipative carpet. Let's hit test again. Six times 10 to the seventh. Pretty close to the same reading we got with the analog meter. This falls right in the middle of static dissipative. If the application were to call for a static dissipative carpet, you've got your winner. Now let's take it and put it on the regular carpet. And by the way, when I say regular carpet, this is commercial grade carpet. It's actually the same carpet style as the one I just tested, but it doesn't have static dissipative properties. When I test it, it measures over 10 to the 10th. I already told you, anything above 1.0 times 10 to the 9th is unacceptable. So low KV carpet, which is what this is, doesn't have any conductivity. What that means is you can't ground it. If you can't ground a floor, you don't have a solution to a static problem. So yesterday I showed you how I could charge up this metal plate and discharge it to these materials. Today I showed you why that metal plate would not discharge to this and why it would discharge to this. The next time we talk, I'll show you other materials, hard surface materials, rubber, vinyl, epoxy. But for today, what we've done is we've shown you why it's important when you write a specification that you actually require the supplier to test the floor after the floor is installed, and in writing, tell you what they got for measurements. You saw how easy the measurements were. It's not that difficult. Thank you for listening.